The views and opinions expressed on the following program are not necessarily those of the staff and management of KLAY or those who advertise their products or services on this station.
That's right, and we think about you day and night, too. You're listening to Viva ENT. This is Johnny the Capo. I'm in the studio with my co-host, who just walked in a little bit late, but on time, Becca the Page.
I was doing your evil bidding.
Oh, good. Yeah. Getting me Gatorade.
Yeah, I got stuck in the machine straight up, and I had to shake it. And
hey, baby. And I have my wonderful producer, Mr.
Eric Ryder.
Eric C.C. Ryder on the show today.
Also doing evil bidding over here.
Oh, yeah.
Should have got here earlier. Could have prevented some of that.
Well, I tell you what, he picked a great song today for the Elvis pick of the week.
He did?
Oh, yeah.
Are you going to tell us?
Not yet. Sure. Well, why not?
Really?
Elvis pick of the week?
Is?
From the movie, Follow That Dream, the title track, Follow That Dream.
I'll be dipped.
And let me tell you what, that is one of Presley's best performances on record ever. I love that song.
And why do you say that?
Well, the song just kind of makes you happy. If it doesn't make you happy, then there's something wrong with you.
Okay. Well, that's some pretty good reasoning,
Let's
I guess,
it makes
there,
you
Johnny.
Happy, then.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Okay, today's guest.
Our
first guest of the day, and we're going to talk about Ricky Nelson today.
Oh, well, that guest.
Oh, I'm a big Ricky Nelson fan myself. Mm-hmm. I like Ricky Nelson, you know. Mm-hmm. So Jerry Osborne's going to be on the show.
Rock and roll historian.
Rock and roll historian. First guest of the day. We're going to feature Ricky Nelson today.
Cool.
No ifs, ends, or buts. And, of course, we still have Coffee with the King. Follow That Dream. So, Elvis fans, don't worry. I'm taking care of you. Don't worry about it.
Great.
Now, second guest of the day. Our buddy, our pal, Jeremiah Kahn.
Yes, Jeremiah is a premier event planner in Seattle, and he does everything for the Seattle Hilton.
That's putting it lightly. The guy's the big shot at the Hilton.
Yep.
Seattle Hilton, that is.
Mm-hmm. He's super fun.
Yeah.
So we're going to be talking about what's new over there at the newly remodeled Seattle Hilton, and I don't know. He probably has a few spreadsheets that he wants to go over when he calls. He's very thorough.
Well, Paige.
Yes.
Are you sleeping or what? Because what about the open house?
I was waiting.
Well, okay, no. Tell us about the open house.
Here's the deal, folks.
Thank you so much.
It's wedding season. A lot of people got engaged over Christmas and Valentine's Day. And right now is the time where people start shopping, some of them for 2015, but most of them for 2016. And we are having an open house. It's open to everybody. All you have to do is go to bridesclub.com.
That's correct.
And click on the RSVP. It's
now
free.
You're thinking, sister.
So, and they also do huge corporate events there, too. So if you'd like to see it for a private party, birthday, corporate event, or a wedding, this is the time to do it. It's open to the public. You're going to walk in, they'll register you, you get some champagne, you get a tour, and then you get to meet with a lot. We have a nice show of vendors.
Right.
Little bit of everything, photography, DJ, makeup, jewelry, clothing, all sorts of cool stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And spend the day there. They have wonderful hors d'oeuvres for everybody, and this event is free, and the parking is free underneath the Hilton.
That's right.
We'd love you to come and meet us.
So, Jeremiah Kahn, our second guest of the afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to talk about the open house at Seattle Hilton this Sunday, April 12th.
Yep, it's from 1 to 5 p.m.
We also have Michelle Culp on the show today.
Mm-hmm.
Is that correct?
We do. Michelle Culp is the owner of Essence of Events. She is an event planner and wedding coordinator.
I've worked with her. She's lovely.
She's lovely. She's got a whole team of girls who work with her, and
she's
they get it done.
She's not one of those pain in the butt wedding coordinators. Is that correct?
She's wonderful.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, now let's talk about what's going on at the Club Hollywood.
Club Hollywood Casino.
I said Hollywood swinging, baby.
I know. We're getting the word out there. They have a wonderful club upstairs.
That's correct.
Amazing. And then they have a full bar, full restaurant, everything from American, tons of Asian food, 50 different types of sushi. In fact, they're famous for their sushi.
Yeah.
And
there's no
they
question.
Have an amazing club with a huge dance floor and a stage and concert sound system and the sound guy and the lighting.
Oh, man.
And
it's good.
We have pretty much taken over on Saturdays. Now, Fridays, this is pretty cool because I know the live music scene in Seattle is pretty large, but I've noticed there isn't a lot of places where you can go to hear just a great classic rock blues band. There's not a lot.
But hold on.
And
hold on.
What?
In a really nice environment.
Yes.
Not like a biker bar. And nothing against biker bars, folks. I like them. But this is a really nice, classy, clean.
Oh, yeah. Couches you can sit on, and then regular tables and chairs, bar bistro tables, chairs, full bar. So you have lots of different seating options, big dance floor. It's a lot of fun. And then Friday nights they have
salsa night.
Yeah, it's a Mediterranean Latin night, and they draw in. They have live band and DJ, and they draw in a lot of people too. So you can go salsa dancing on Friday and then come and rock out with us on Saturday nights over
That's
there,
correct.
Starting at 9 o'clock.
So, in other words, what she's trying to say is that I, Johnny the Capo, will be on stage 9 p.m., Club Hollywood in Shoreline. Be there because we're rocking the house.
It's right on Aurora.
There's no question.
Lots of parking.
No question we're rocking the house.
Yeah. Yeah, that's okay. What we want. You know, we've got a really good following, but... You know, we want to invite Seattle to come check this out. It's a lot of fun.
As a matter of fact, we're going to play one of my cuts from my new album right before we go to commercial. Want to talk about our buddy.
Oh, Bob. Bob Delph.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm.
New member of the Saturn Barter Club.
Yep.
Let's talk about it.
Okay. Well, Bob owns Northwest Cellars.
That's correct.
And he has a wine tasting room, and he sells wine, and this is very... delicious, high-quality wine.
That's
this
right.
Isn't box wine.
Yeah.
It's wonderful. Yeah. And he says that he is a wine geek, and I absolutely
I believe him.
And then he also does something that's really cool is custom labels on the wine bottle. So you can design it, or they can design the graphic and then put it right on every wine bottle. So it's great for gifts and parties and weddings and corporate events to get your name out there, too. So
yeah.
It's a cool service.
The custom label type thing, I'm going to order from this week myself, personally.
Fun.
I'm going to come up with some theme, and I'm going to get myself 25 bottles of Chardonnay.
Really?
What do you think about that?
I think it's just an excuse to get 25 bottles of Chardonnay.
Well, I think it's a good excuse.
Okay. You should just get the label that says Johnny's Wine.
I'm going to say more like the Capo's Wine.
Capo Wine.
I want to talk about the American Pacific Mortgage, ladies and gentlemen. I was there today. These guys are classy. They make you understand what you need to do about refinancing, mortgages, everything that you need to know in plain language. Mm-hmm. And I was working with Michael House today. I was also working with Jonathan Maddich.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, two great guys. So American Pacific Mortgage. Can you see the number off the card?
Well, of course I can.
I need my glasses.
American Pacific Mortgage, it's 425-967-8866. Good thing you brought up a mortgage company, especially American Pacific Mortgage, because the housing market's fierce right now, and there is a lot of competition, and you need to get completely pre-qualified, ready to go to buy a house. If you're going to go look at a house for sale, especially in Seattle or Snohomish, you go look at that house, you need to have all your ducks in a row and be ready to buy right then, because there's a 1% vacancy rate right now.
Yeah, and not only that, I hear like 60,000 people are going to move into Seattle in the next 10 years.
Yep. So if you get a good mortgage broker, you're in good hands. You can walk right in, say, I like this house, let's do it. I want it sold right there at the open house. So call Michael House. His direct number is 425-329-4790, or it's Michael H. at aplending.com.
And give my buddy Jonathan a plug, too.
His email is jonathanm at aplending.com, and I already gave you his number. It's 425-967-8866.
Ladies and gentlemen, guys and dolls, cats and chicks, we're going to listen to Johnny and the Bad Boys mostly rocking really hard. It's called Such a Rush.
She walks like she's on a cloud. She never ever speaks to a lie. She could be the queen of the world. She just wants to be my girl. It's such a rush, baby. Oh, when you touch me, baby. It's such a rush, baby. When you love me, baby. Baby, it's such a rush, baby. When you love it, baby.
Right, it's such a rush, baby. Club Hollywood, John and the Bad Boys this Saturday, 9 p.m. A word from our sponsors.
Lights, camera, action. Capture those precious moments at your special event with 1,000 Words Events friendly, fun party services. Make your guests smile with a unique photo booth. Bring the celebration anywhere with a green screen. Enhance the mood with event lighting or pile them in an awesome VW photo bus. Our services provide lasting memories and unique party favors. After all, a picture's worth 1,000 words. See for yourself what we do at 1000wordevents.com or call us at 253-380-2026. Let's make some memories. Online at 1000wordevents.com or 253-380-2026.
Attention business owners, experience a new world of business with barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9930, or online at SaturnBarter.com.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to BridesClub.com, that's BridesClub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers, and don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to BridesClub.com. Check out BridesClub.com.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rentals specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalslaw.com.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood, Tacoma, on 1180 AM.
Da-da-da.
Da-da-da.
Hello, Johnny.
Hey, how you doing, Becca?
I'm good. How are you?
Say hi, Erica, our producer here.
Hey, good afternoon.
All right.
We're all here.
And we have our buddy and pal, Jerry Osborne. Rock and roll historian.
Friend of the show.
That's right. Jerry?
I think I'll have a new business card printed that after my name it says RRH, for rock and roll historian.
I like it. Yeah. How do you become a rock and roll historian? Because I think I already am one.
Well, I think that if you think you are, that you probably are, and that's how you become one.
So it's just a self-declaration?
Absolutely.
With a reputation.
And think of all you save in educational student loans and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, very
well, Johnny,
nice.
Guess what? You're now officially a rock and roll historian. I dub you. Boom. Boom.
Well, I like the dub. Is that dub?
I dubbed you, yeah.
I like to be dubbed.
Into knighthood.
And I'll take it. And from this day forward, I will think as that.
Sir Johnny, rock and roll historian.
Now, my pal, Mr. Osborne, wants to talk about Ricky Nelson. And Eric, do you know much about Ricky Nelson off the top of your head?
He was the son of a famous TV personality, right?
Yes. But also...
And he became one...
Ozzy Nelson?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he was part of a TV family and had success covering Fats Domino, I think, for his first big hit, right?
That's correct.
Yeah.
And you know what, Eric, a lot of people don't realize that Ricky Nelson, he was kind of born into the TV show, but he was a major, major player when it came to being a pop teen idol, a reputable record seller. He sold lots of records.
So, now, wait till you get around to asking me how many and how he ranks in the big picture overall.
Well, I know this off the top of my head, that he definitely at one time was in the top 3-4 highest-selling male vocalists of all time. At one time.
Well, you're absolutely right. Now's as good a time any to go into the big picture. Overall, he is in the top 25 selling artist of singles records, not counting LPs, just singles.
Correct.
Of all time. And that includes male, female, groups, everybody. He's in the top 25.
Right.
Now, taking it a step further, and I think this is one of the things that people should know about him, and they probably don't. Only two people in the entire decade of the 50s who could be considered rock and roll singers had number one albums. Elvis had four in 1956 and 57. Rick had one in 57. And he is the only other artist who could be considered a rock and roll singer, male or female, who had a number one album before Meet the Beatles. So we're talking about from the beginning of LPs all the way to the first month of 1964, only Rick and Elvis had number one LPs.
That's incredible.
It is, and it says a couple of things. First of all, that Rick was popular, and second, that LPs were not really what the teenagers were buying at the time. They were buying singles, and LPs were generally bought more by adults, and that's why a lot of the top-selling LPs from that period are soundtracks or pop stuff, like, say, Mitch Miller or the Kingston Trio and things like that, but not really the rock stars. And they didn't start having hit albums until the Beatles.
That is correct, sir. Absolutely. Yeah, you're absolutely right about that. You know, and of course, there was EPs in those days, too. Did Ricky have a lot of EPs?
He did.
I thought so.
Absolutely. In fact, he was second only to Elvis in the number of charted EPs that he had.
Uh-huh.
He had five, which is a lot when it comes to EPs, and that was all from 57 to 59. So in that two-year period, he had five charted EPs, so that's kind of neat, too.
That is absolutely a correct and right, and the EPs were like a big thing because, like you said earlier, not everybody had enough money to buy an album.
Me! Look, I'm thinking of my own teenage years, and I would go to the record store, and I would hold the 12-inch LP and look at the $3 price tag on it, and then I had the 45 option, which was usually under a dollar. Well, the EP was sort of a middle ground, so for $1.29, you could get four songs instead of two if you couldn't afford 12.
You know what? That's so crazy because I remember standing in record stores, putting four or five different covers on the and looking at the one and say, "Which one can I afford? Which one can I buy?"
All the time.
All the time.
Yeah, you come down to like between three different artists, three different new releases, and you're like, "What am I gonna do here?" So you know what you do? You have two other friends, each buy one, and then you all swap.
And that's when you started putting your name on the labels, thereby devaluing them in the
yep.
overall history of things. Let me tell you another little-known trivia tidbit about Greg Nelson. Other than the fact that I worked quite a number of shows with him over my life, and we were friends, and I loved him, but he and Elvis each had, get this, 17 different charted songs in 1 year, and no one else other than the Beatles, and they are a group, but we'll say no other non-group entertainer had 17 hit songs on the national charts in one calendar year, and he and Elvis both did in separate years, Elvis in 56 and Rick in 63. But that's something.
Yeah. You know, another thing, too, that Rick had that huge hit with Fools Rush In, right during the Beatle invasion.
Well, right? That was one of the 17.
Yeah.
That's on the list of the ones I just mentioned, yeah.
That was 64, I'm pretty sure. Is that right?
Well, it was 63, but
okay.
it carried over and was still popular in early 64, too.
Mm-hmm. That's right, exactly.
And he also had more two-sided hits than probably anybody except maybe Elvis and perhaps Connie Francis or Brenda Lee, but he had a lot of two-sided hits, which was not always easy to do.
Yeah, you know... the fact of the matter is, Rick Nelson was huge. Huge.
Yeah.
And he doesn't get... You know, the thing about Ricky Nelson is he doesn't... You know, like a lot of the teen idols of the day, they don't get the credit that they really deserved. I mean, okay, maybe Ricky didn't write his own songs, but he was a great artist in the studio. What about Lonesome Town? You know what I mean?
Yeah, with the Jordanaires.
Lonesome Town was with the Jordanaires?
Yeah. Well, the Jordanaires backed Rick on a lot of his early stuff.
I know
and
that.
And, of course, he had James Burton on lead guitar, who
you know
later
that?
Went
mm-hmm.
with Elvis in
mm-hmm.
the 70s.
Mm-hmm.
And Rick did start writing his own songs, too,
towards
around
the
time of Garden Party.
Exactly.
Yeah, he wrote stuff.
He recorded that Bob Dylan song, what was that, She's Not You or Not... He had a minor hit with the Bob Dylan song right in that era, 70, 71. I'll think of it in a second, but I'm surprised you haven't.
I Shall Be Released?
Yeah, it was actually released. Yeah, it was.
No, I Shall Be Released.
No, that was...
Oh, She Belongs to Me?
That's it.
Okay.
That's it. She Belongs to Me. That's, I knew you'd be on it, Jerem. For sure.
You mentioned, or someone mentioned a moment ago about his covering Fats Domino's I'm Walking.
Right.
Well, that was one side of his first hit, which I might add got up to number two, so it just barely missed being number one.
Yeah.
But Fats Domino told me once that when Rick did his song is one of the best things that ever happened to him, because he wrote it and he got all the songwriting royalties,
right.
And so he had a million seller of his own on it, and then Rick turns around and has another million seller on it, so it worked out really well for Mr. Domino.
Yeah, and in those days, artists got paid, you know. They thought they had it bad in those days. What about these days? If you know what I mean.
Yeah. So anyway, it's fun to talk about him today.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Ricky Nelson, and as a matter of fact, he doesn't get the credit, you know, when he towards the end of his career, or early after, I'd say 73, probably 74 is when he had the Stone Canyon Band. Remember that?
Well, he had the Stone Canyon Band beginning in 69.
Okay.
And his last charted hit was 73.
Okay.
So you're pretty much right in the period there.
Yeah, but, you know, Randy Meisner from the Eagles played in that band.
Yeah, you're right.
And he was actually creating a style that would actually explode onto the scene, you know, in the early 70s, mid-70s.
Yeah.
Eagles, Poco, that type of thing.
Sure, even in the pop country field, acts like the Bellamy Brothers and, you know, a number of other ones, Starland Vocal Band. I mean, there was a lot of that style around at that time.
Yeah, so as an artist, I feel the same way about Elvis as I do Ricky Nelson. I don't think they really got their credit. You know what I mean?
And they were both excellent singers, too. I mean, that's another thing that a lot of people know, but some people might not realize it. But Rick was a very good singer.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to feature Rick right now with I'm Walkin'. And shortly after that, we're going to feature Follow That Dream. That's right.
Sounds good.
I'm walking, yes indeed.
I'm talking for you and me, and I'm hoping that you come back to me. I'm lonely as I can be, and I've waited for your company, and I'm hoping that you come back to me. What you gonna do when the well runs dry? You're gonna run away and hide. I'm gonna run right by your side. You pretty baby, I'd even die. I'm walking. Yes, indeed, I'm talking for you and me, and I'm hoping that you come back to me. Hang on.
Jerry Osborne, that's a hot record. What do you think?
I think so.
Number one record, number two?
It rated number two on Billboard, so that's pretty darn good.
Yeah, you know, that's a great arrangement there. You know, he did that guitar lead and the saxophone lead. Very, very, very cool.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, Joe, we're out of time here on this segment. Would you be kind enough to tell our listeners how they can get a hold of you, check out your work, your books, and all the stuff that you do?
Well, there's just a world of information available at jerryosborne.com.
Cool.
That's all. Go there or be square.
And you're working on a special Ricky Nelson project right now, is that correct?
Well, it's just that I did, in fact, complete one. Our current version of our giant Rockin' Records book has a two-page color gallery of all of the picture sleeves and all of the EPs that Rick had in his career. So it's nice to see those all together, because there's never been a gallery of all of his stuff in, we'll say, one page or one presentation. And so we wanted to do them all in one. So it took two pages, but it's a beautiful spread.
And where can our listeners check that out? On your website?
JerryOsborne.com. Yeah, yeah. It's the current edition for 2015 of Rockin' Records.
Okay, man. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Okay.
Thank you now, and see you later, brother.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, a word from our sponsors.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They're your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rentals specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368 or go to grandeventrentalslaw.com.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9930, or online at SaturnBarter.com.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to BridesClub.com. That's BridesClub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers, and don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to BridesClub.com. Check out BridesClub.com.
Lights, camera, action. Capture those precious moments at your special event with 1,000 Words Events friendly, fun party services. Make your guests smile with a unique photo booth. Bring the celebration anywhere with a green screen. Enhance the mood with event lighting or pile them in an awesome VW photo bus. Our services provide lasting memories and unique party favors. After all, a picture's worth 1,000 words. See for yourself what we do at 1000wordevents.com or call us at 253-380-2026. Let's make some memories. Online at 1000wordevents.com or 253-380-2026.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood Tacoma on 1180 AM.
All right. This is Johnny the Capo in the studio. Viva ENT. I'm here with my co-host,
Becca Page,
my producer,
Eric Ryder,
and my buddy and pal on the air live with us right now, Jeremiah Kahn.
That's me. I'm back again.
Hey, Jeremiah.
Hi. How are you guys today?
You're so funny. When you call, you're just like a jack-in-the-box. You're like, hi, I'm here. Hey.
That's me.
Peek-a-boo.
Hey, we got a big thing going on this Sunday, don't we?
Oh, yeah. Actually, I spent a good chunk of my day kind of getting all of the logistics in place.
Cool.
We have our Hilton and Viva Productions Brides Club wedding showcase.
Okay.
So we're very excited. We have about 10 vendors lined up. You know, Fun Frames Photo Booth is going to be here.
Okay.
Iceworks Northwest. Illusions of Grandeur Photography.
Cool.
Countryside Floral. We're going to have some makeup from Mary Kay.
Very good.
A couple of efficients. Of course, the pop famous Viva Productions.
Well, you better believe
we're going to be here from the Hilton Seattle representing. So if any of you brides out there are still looking for any of your vendors, this is not only a great chance for you to find that, but also potentially scope out a great venue. So,
And you know what I'm stoked about, too, is what Countryside Floral is doing for us again.
Oh, yes, and I almost don't want to spoil a surprise.
I know, right?
Because it's going to be so cool. And John and I actually were on the phone for probably a good 30 minutes yesterday talking about the colors and everything. And I guess the hint is that it's going to give you brides out there lots of ideas for your centerpieces. That's all
Very
I'm going to
cool.
say.
Well, he's by far the most creative florist in all of Puget Sound, by far.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
He does some just absolutely amazing stuff that, you know, if flowers could walk a runway,
they would.
He would be Giorgio Armani. You know?
Yeah.
They're really cool. So I'm super excited to see that.
Yeah, and I love it because all the vendors that are coming to this are kind of like handpicked by us as some of the top, you know, in the industry, which is always good because, you know, you go to wedding shows and there's so many choices out there and you don't know what they're going to do, this and that. But you know that when you're coming to something like this, they're almost kind of like pre-qualified for being the top notch and still not breaking the bank, you know?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I like that.
Mm-hmm. So that's going to be fun. It's this Sunday from 1 to 5.
Yes. And, oh, something else I forgot to mention about it is our chef, Lloyd Titus is actually going to be preparing appetizers for all of the brides and grooms to try them out so they can sample some of the food we have. When they walk in, we're going to have champagne ready for you so you can walk our hotel in the spaces with a glass of champagne. And we'll also be paying for your parking. So,
nice.
That's huge. Free parking in the heart of downtown Seattle, you're not going to find that anywhere.
No.
Yeah. So it's totally complimentary. And it's just a great way for people to come and kind of scope it out. I know a lot of people, we just had Valentine's Day, probably just got engaged. So this is a great way to get the planning process going. So
And tell everybody about the top room.
Oh, yeah. So we actually completed a multi-million-dollar renovation at the end of August in 2014.
Yeah.
And when we did that, we used to have a restaurant off the top of the Hilton. We took it out, and now it's private meeting space. So it's perfect for weddings, social events, birthdays. And so the flow of our upcoming wedding showcase is you're going to check in on the 10th floor.
Uh-huh.
We're going to have our ballroom stage for a wedding event.
Cool.
And then there'll be probably about 6 to 8 vendors on the ballroom level, so you can kind of get your fair share of them. And then the fun doesn't stop there. You take a short elevator ride to the top of the Hilton where there's more vendors, and then that's where you're also going to find some of the appetizers and all of that stuff, and you'll be able to take in the view as well. So that top floor space is really, we haven't even had a wedding up there because it's such new event space.
It's cool up there.
It's cool, and yeah. The view is very unique. So,
is that the skyline, the sky room, or sky
so
view?
It's 2 rooms. So there's the skyline room, which actually has a very good view of the skyline, hence the name. And then next to it is the sound view room, which has a nice view of the sound. And then if you book the 2 of them together, it is the top of the Hilton. So it's kind of all of them. So you don't have to book them all, but typically we do because we would obviously never put 2 weddings on the same night. So, it's going to be a really great event. If you don't have anything to do, it is kind of a drop-in any time between 1 and 5 p.m.
Cool.
Don't feel like you're going to miss anything. Just stop by at your convenience, and we'll be here. So.
You know, I've been to the top of the Hilton many times, even when it was a restaurant and since after. It has a unique view, a very unique view.
Yeah, and I think a lot of it has to do with our perspective on the city. You know, from Alki, you look at the skyline, and it's just square buildings. But from our location, you get to see, you know, the triangle architecture of the Metropolitan Tower or the rounded arch of, some of the other buildings. And you still get the Space Needle and everything. And even there are a few venues in downtown Seattle that do have top floor space, but they are surrounded by buildings. So your view is basically looking into another building.
Yeah, you're in a unique location where you don't get a view any other place but from there, like yours.
Pretty much, yeah. It's pretty special. I mean, I was at the Columbia Tower Club yesterday for an event, and they have of course, a very nice view. But
of course.
I liked ours almost a little bit better because it seemed like as high up as we were, everything was really small. And in our venue, you're high up, but everything is still like quite large. And it's very, you walk in, and it's kind of like a big awe factor. Like you're,
it is, yeah. You're like, I can't stop looking at all of this stuff.
Yeah, and I can't tell you how many times I'm touring a bride of the space. We get off the elevator and take a left, and I literally get like a like
yeah.
a gasp out loud.
Well,
them,
it's so. It definitely kind of shows the history of Seattle just from right there. You know, you've got those buildings that are almost 100 years old standing next to the latest architecture. So
yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
and I
it's
mean,
fun.
It's special because our hotel is pretty historic as well. I mean, it was built back in 1950, you know, and
right.
that's almost 65 years that this building has been in service. And it's been a Hilton since day one.
Wow.
And it was actually the first Hilton hotel, like, in the city of Seattle, so it was a big deal. And even one of the things, anybody out there listening, if they're going to attend, the elevator lobby has Baja onyx on the walls, which is 75 million years old, and it's got, the whole building has just so much really fun history to it, so it's not many hotels can say something like that.
And
you know?
They really put some thought behind that remodel, didn't they?
Exactly. I mean, you know, a lot of hotels out there, they renovate and they go a little too crazy. It almost looks like the circus threw up in the hotel. but with us, you know, they did it very modern and tasteful and still, you know, trendy, but not over the top where you get dizzy, you know. So it's very elegant and classy are the words I like to use.
Yeah, looks like it belongs in a magazine.
I would
exactly.
say that.
And it's very posh. That's another good word.
Yes, and stylish, too.
Stylish. There's all these good adjectives
We're
about
all just
it,
like,
so.
Let's just have adjective moment here.
Yes.
So are we going to have a little champagne Sunday at the show?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Actually, you walk in the door,
okay,
you fill
okay.
out registration, and we'll have a champagne glass ready to go for you. So, and you'll get another one up at the top. So, of course.
It sounds like a great show. Jeremiah, tell our listeners how they can get a hold of you if they're interested in booking the Seattle Hilton for an event, wedding, private party.
Everything. So there's lots of different ways you can do it. My direct line here at the hotel is 206-695-6060. You can always send me an email or, of course, drop in. We're located right at the corner of 6th and University, so very centrally located within the city. You can park in our parking garage, and when people are coming out for tours, I always will cover that. And if you're interested and have the time, I'm always going to treat you to lunch or happy hour. So.
Ooh, I didn't know that.
I'm coming. I'm coming.
I should be careful about who I say that.
I know. You just told all of Seattle lunch is on you.
Well, it's true. If all of Seattle is
oh,
willing
no.
to come in here with a meeting for us, I will treat you
oh,
all
there you
lunch,
go. There, so. I knew there was a catch. With the meeting for us.
Jeremiah, we love you, man. Thanks for being on
thank
the show.
Thank you so much. We're excited to see you guys. So take care.
Thank you. We're going to take it out with a little Follow That Dream. You know, we play Presley every week on this show, and here it is right here, right now. The King.
Follow that dream. Gets restless, time to move along. When your heart gets weary, time to sing a song. But when a dream is calling you, there's just one thing that you can do. You gotta follow that dream wherever that dream may lead. You gotta follow that dream to find the love in me. Gotta find me someone whose heart is free. Someone to look for my dream with me. And when I find her, I may find out just what my dreams are all about. I gotta follow that dream wherever that dream may lead. I gotta follow that dream to find the love I need. I'm
Lights, camera, action. Capture those precious moments at your special event with 1,000 Words Events friendly, fun party services. Make your guests smile with a unique photo booth. Bring the celebration anywhere with a green screen. Enhance the mood with event lighting or pile them in an awesome VW photo bus. Our services provide lasting memories and unique party favors. After all, a picture's worth 1,000 words. See for yourself what we do at 1000wordevents.com or call us at 253-380-2026. Let's make some memories. Online at 1000wordevents.com or 253-380-2026.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals' customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rental specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalslaw.com.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood Tacoma on 1180 AM.
Okay, folks, we are back. This is Becca Page with Viva ENT, and I am so excited because I've been trying to get her on forever. I have Michelle Culp from Essence of Events on the phone right now. I've worked with a million wedding coordinators, event planners, and she is by far my favorite, and she's got this incredible reputation all over Puget Sound, so it's not just me. Everybody loves her, and everybody knows she is absolutely solid in what she does. So, Michelle, say hello.
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 Hi.
Was that an okay introduction, or would you like me to go on?
You could go on. We can keep going. Really want to.
Well,
who doesn't like to hear about it?
You have been in this industry a very long time, and
yeah.
you do have a website. What's the website, real quick?
It's EssenceOfEvents.com.
That's super easy.
Yeah,
and you do
very
a
easy.
Lot of weddings, and you have some people who work for you as well, correct?
Yeah. So what we have is several different planners and assistants, and then we also do internships. So
ooh.
We train different people to come in and learn about our company and the industry. And then from there, if they decide to stay with us, then we're happy to have them.
That's really cool that you do that. I've talked to some people who have called a lot of different wedding coordinators and asked them about internships, and they're just told, absolutely not, I don't create my own competition. But you create people who work with you.
No, and, you know, I love to encourage other people to just do whatever they want to do and support them in their dreams, because
mm-hmm.
that's one of the things that I've been doing. So.
Right.
I think it's important to encourage people in whatever they decide to do. And that's a lot of what we do with our clients, too. So we work with them to figure out what it is that they want for their special day and then just kind of just build from that
mm-hmm.
and make sure they get what they want.
So when you're meeting with a client for the very first time, they've just got engaged, never planned a wedding, never been to a wedding, they have no idea what the heck to do.
Yeah.
Do the majority of them just say, hey, you know, what do I do? Take my hand, guide me along the way? Or do you get a lot of them that are like, well, this is what I want to do, and they don't really think about anything other than this? Are you following what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
You know
course.
What I mean? Like, you have some that are that have their own mind on something, and they just don't know anything about the industry, and you have to kind of, like, gently set them straight about how it is.
So yeah. The thing that's unique about people in general is that we're all different. So what I try to do is when I'm meeting with a couple is figure out what drew them to each other and why they love each other so much that they want to get married. So I try to build off of that and then figure out if they have parents involved. Mm-hmm. So if they actually have sat down and gone over a budget.
Mm-hmm.
And I figure out maybe even if they're in the beginning stages and they don't know what they want, then I guide them along to figure out, well, based off of what your favorite colors are or where you like to go or, you know, things you like to do, then we kind of build off of that.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of couples, they have an idea of what they want, but they just don't know how to get there, and they're really concerned about staying in budget, and also they're concerned about hiring professional vendors, which is a top concern from clients that come in, for sure.
Absolutely. And I had a really cool meeting last week with a couple that they're both, I wouldn't say they're shy, but they're both just very reserved, laid-back people.
Yeah.
They don't want a lot of attention brought on them. And so, you know, as a DJ, you're trying to help them plan their wedding. And
yeah.
And most of the time when you get these reserved couples, you're going, oh boy, because you don't want to be overbearing and take away from the bride and groom's day. But when they're so quiet, it's like they're almost not there. You're trying to do something to try to even the playing field and keep the guests engaged and keep the attention on them. So this couple,
I mean, it is a challenge for sure. Because when we sit down with couples, there are some that are like very direct about what they want.
Mm-hmm.
But then there are others, like you said, that kind of just sit back and are waiting for you to kind of show what you do, basically,
mm-hmm.
And have you step forward. And so with them, a lot of times I have a very detailed questionnaire from, like, what are their favorite places to go and what do they normally do? Or, like, even funny questions, like, what was the last thing that they bought for themselves? Or, like, for the groom, if he's sitting in a doctor's office, what kind of magazine would he pick up? And that kind of draws them out and opens them up to feel a little more comfortable.
Mm-hmm. And then what do you do with that?
So with that information, based off of that, I just get an idea of the type of couple they are, and it also makes them feel more comfortable with me. So they open mm-hmm. up a little bit more, and they feel like we have better communication that way, and they mm-hmm. feel like they can share. So, like, one of the questions is, what's a favorite shared experience? So something they've gone through together that maybe brought them closer.
Mm-hmm.
So it just draws them out in a way that I get to know them on a personal level, and they see, you know, that I'm a human too, and that I truly care about people. That's one of the main reasons that
Absolutely.
I decided to go into this, is because my main concern is looking out for my clients and them getting what they want
and
for
deserve,
their wedding.
And absolutely
yeah,
deserve.
And deserve. Yeah. I mean, everybody deserves to be happy. And what is better than having a job where you get to look around a room and see smiling faces and everybody having a good time and knowing that you had a part in that?
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
You'll
I just
have a
love
forever
my job.
Part of it. Yeah.
It's
a really special
that lasts forever.
It's something really special that we're involved in, because every time we go to work, we are literally part of one of the most important days of two people's lives.
Yeah,
it's so
it will never
powerful.
Never forgotten. Mm-hmm. Never forgotten.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
I absolutely love what I do.
Yeah, and I like you because you're kind of like a little mama bear. You know, you take care of them and make sure they're okay. But if anybody gets in the way of their happiness,
it's true.
You deal with a hired professional.
Yeah, I mean, well, a lot of times there are conflicts that do come up, and it may be between the clients and the vendors, or between vendors, yeah, or our clients and their family. And my job the entire time is to continue to support my couples. They hired me. You know, their parents, you know, didn't hire me. The vendors didn't hire me. I'm working for my clients. I am 100% on their side. So,
cool.
You know, there may be things that I recommend and I may suggest just based on my experience, but in the end, they make the final decision, and I'm going to support that 100%, even if it means that, you know, maybe a mother's going to be upset with me because I have to tell her that her sister can't sing at, you know, her daughter's wedding or whatever.
She can't sing Amazing Grace.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Michelle, we are at the end of the clock. This went really fast, didn't it?
Oh,
see how easy
well, thank
that is?
You. Yeah, I know. I know.
No, we're going to get you on for a half hour next time because this is so much fun, and there was a lot more I wanted to discuss with you. So we're going to do it again. But,
okay,
folks,
good.
This is Michelle Culp. She's the owner of Essence of Events, Event Planning. You can find her online at essenceofevents.com. And thank you again, Michelle, and I will talk to you very soon.
Have a wonderful day.
Thanks. Thank you so much for being on the show.
One more thing I wanted to say and reach out and say hello, Kate, over at Omni Systems. She's
very cool.
Listening. And she says I have a very soothing voice. So, Kate.
Oh, yes, you do.
Kate, I love you.
Now, can I give a plug to John in the Bad Boys Club Hollywood Casino this Saturday, 9 p.m.?
Absolutely.
Featuring DJ, classic rock, and also we're going to be at the Seattle Hilton on Sunday.
Yes, we are.
That's right. So, we'll dig you now.
And we'll see you later.
Oh.
Wait, you can't just...
Rochelle Wright.
Okay, quick.
Rochelle Wright will be with us.
Okay.
At the Club Hollywood Casino.
Awesome.
I'm telling you, girl.
We'll dig you now and see you later.
Because you're a fine sweet potato.
Bye-bye, guys.
Thank you so much.